A landmark agreement has been made among the nation's energy ministers tonight with a plan to fund a rapid transition to renewable energy. It will do little to ease power bill pain in the short term. That's set for tougher negotiations at National Cabinet tomorrow.
Chris Bowen and New South Wales Energy Minister Matt Keane arriving in stride to today's power powwow in more ways than one.
I want to make it very clear that New South Wales is willing to forego any royalties. This is not about royalties, this is all about consumers.
One of two coal states, the New South Wales government will now prioritise low-income power relief, leaving the Sunshine State in the dark on a national energy agreement, seeking compensation for lost revenue and royalties from coal fire production.
We're going to agree to push consumer prices down, to push business prices down on electricity bills.
Emerging hours later...
Well, those lights are bright today.
..with a long-term agreement for a coordinated plan for transition to renewables with major investments in wind, solar, batteries and pumped hydro.
This is a sensible, carefully designed mechanism which will unleash investment in clean, dispatchable energy right across Australia.
This is the biggest win in that transition so far. We're going to massively implement the plan to transition. The transition is unstoppable.
A cleaner, greener long-term future, but the more immediate struggle made clear to the minister by a mum from Melbourne on Today Show.
You've got to make choices now. You know, the money you saved for Christmas now has to be paid, on energy bills.
We are being upfront about the pressures and we're acting. So we do need to act.
Gas price caps, part of a suite being taken to the National Cabinet meeting tomorrow, a bet on lower prices for Australians in the short term, but the industry warns there's long-term impacts.
These heavy-handed, radical interventions in the market will absolutely see companies looking at their investments and whether they're still viable.
The Prime Minister remains in consultation with the Premiers, isolated at Kirribilli House, on the phone, and tonight, on the clock. Charles Croucher, Nine News.